Now it is a privilege to be joined by Showtime Pettis to talk about it. Anthony, how are you?
I'm good, man. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Wow, this is exciting stuff. I mean, just seeing the graphic on our screen right now, facing Nate Diaz, UFC 241, August 17th. This is amazing. When did you first hear that this was a potential fight for you next?
About a week ago, I think. Abe, my manager, hit me up and said there was talks in the works. But for me, I didn't take it serious. I was like, I'll see what happens, see what other names pop up. And then Sean Shelby hit me up and told me, hey, we got Nate ready to go. Co-main event in California. You down? And I said, send the contract.
Wow. And what was your like, what did you think when this was brought to your attention?
Oh, man, a perfect fight for me. Me and Nate, we've had beef and drama for a long time. So, just something that was supposed to happen a long time ago, and it's finally happening, and at a comfortable weight class for both of us, so it's going to be a scrap.
Could you tell us the history there? Because I do understand it. This is years in the making. Where did this all start between you two?
Man, honestly, I don't even remember. I know I was the champ, and I don't remember when the actual what event took place, but we just always had this drama, and every time we saw each other, it was just always something was gonna happen, So it was just one of them things. I think he might have been jealous. I was the champ. He wanted a shot at me. Then he got his McGregor fight, and then he went MIA. So that chapter never closed in my life. So for me, this is something that had to happen.
I don't know if you remember this, but I remember, I think it was UFC 188 in Mexico. I was backstage and you guys were like exchanging words or something like this and kind of had to be a little bit separated. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I feel like Nate always did that. He waited for the kids to show up and then he'd yap at the mouth. I coached against Gilbert Melendez the whole Ultimate Fighter season, not one word, didn't say anything. And then, the camera's around, he has something to say. So it's time to back it up. Everything he's been talking, all the stuff he's been saying, and then all the drama he's been trying to cause at the UFC events, I'm like, all right, let's settle it now. And I'm in the octagon exactly how I want it. And, man, I'm excited for this fight, 100% motivated. I want to knock this guy out.
So you kind of feel like he sort of, like, acts tough in front of the cameras, but then when it's face-to-face, no one's around.
No, I mean, I think Nate is a tough dude, man, but he just turns on for the cameras. It's like for that, for example, for sure. You were interviewing him, or I don't know what was going on, but I'm walking past, and I know Gilbert just lost, I think.
Yep.
And he just started talking. It's crazy, And it was just like another one of the things, like, bro, I seen you the night before. Why didn't you say anything the night before? Now you got something to say. So it is what it is, man. I'm past that drama stuff, but I'm definitely looking forward to whooping his ass.
And, we've been down this road. Like, when I reported this fight on Saturday, I got so many comments from people saying, like, I'll believe it when I see it. I don't believe a Diaz fight is going to happen anymore. Do you feel like this is going to happen? We just went through something with Dustin Poirier and the fight never materialized, even though bout agreements were signed. Do you feel like this is actually going to happen?
Well, I feel like he has... we don't like each other, man. So I feel like it's not like just a fight for him. This is some personal stuff. So I feel like this is something he wants to do. So I mean, I did what I had to do. I signed a contract. I'm ready to fight August 17th. I will be there. It's on him now.
How do you feel about the fight taking place at 170 as opposed to 155?
I love it, man. It's a real fight. Well, I mean, 155, we'll both be dying trying to make weight, and then, our performances. I mean, obviously we both could fight at 155, but 170, this is a straight up fight.
And so before this was brought to your attention, of course, we know what happened against Wonderboy. You looked so good, and we talked about you potentially sticking around. Was that the plan, regardless of if it was Nate Diaz next or someone else? Were you planning on sticking around at 170? Had you made that decision?
I haven't, man. Honestly, me and Duke just been sitting back and just trying to see what materialized. I mean, honestly, there were some big names thrown my way. Conor McGregor was thrown my way from Dana. I thought that was going to happen in New York, like in August, but then... That didn't happen, so I pulled back. I just sat out for a little bit, just hanging out, training, and then Diaz pops up. So, I mean, it's perfect.
So I had heard that the UFC was planning to go to New York, but that was July 27th, MSG, and that the Conor thing was a potential there. He actually called you and told you about this?
Yeah, he called me and told me about it. Yeah, asked me if I would take the fight. I want to fight the best. I want to be remembered as the guy who fought everybody, man. Like, I'm close to fighting... mostly guys in 155 that are in the top 10. 170, I just started over here, so I feel like there's a lot of good names out there for me to fight.
Would that have been at 155 or 170 against Conor?
I don't know. We didn't get that far.
Okay.
We just got a date and an opponent.
Whoa, and why did it fall through, to the best of your knowledge?
No idea. He just said you know, he's like, just stay ready. That's all Dana said.
Whoa. And were you disappointed when it fell through?
I mean, honestly, like I said, bro, I was going to stay busy regardless. Like July or August was the latest I wanted to fight. So, for me, it was just waiting for an opponent. But when you get names like that, you know, it just makes it exciting. I fought everybody. So like, I need these big names to make me excited.
Considering the backstory with Diaz, and if you had to choose between Diaz and McGregor, which fight excites you more?
Diaz.
Wow, more than McGregor.
Diaz, 100%, man. I just don't like the guy.
Wow, I've never heard you say this about anyone before.
Nah, and that's how it is. You know, I'm not that dude, but this is just one guy I don't like.
Wow. So this is literally years. This is no joke. Like, you're not like playing this up for the fight. You really legitimately dislike this man.
I don't do that, man. Like, I don't come out public. I don't need to talk trash. My fighting style speaks for itself. But me and Diaz just don't. We got problems, and now we get to solve them.
To the best of your knowledge, has he signed his bout agreement? Have they told you this?
No idea, man. I don't ask questions about that dude.
Okay. I had also heard that it's going to be the co-main event. Were you told that as well?
Yeah, my contract said co-main event, so three rounds.
All right. And you are fighting on his turf in California. How do you feel about that?
Oh, man, his turf. I don't think it's enemy territory at all. I got a lot of family in California. You can go. My cousin lives out in a lot of my family are in California. I mean, it doesn't matter to me. Like I said, this is something that I wanted to happen for a long time, and it's finally here. And August can't come soon enough.
He hasn't fought in 3 years. By the time this fight happens, it will be almost exactly 3 years since his last fight. What kind of Nate Diaz are you expecting to see?
I don't even care, man. I just can't wait to put my hands on this dude. I mean, hopefully he's in shape and he's ready to go, but I don't care. Like, when they said his name, send the contract. That's all I said.
Oh, my gosh. I really have never heard you talk like this before. This is amazing. Do you feel like there's, like, a fire lit under you because of this now?
I mean, I already had a fire lit, and my goals are already in front of me, what I want for obviously my career, but a guy like that, you know, I'll fight somebody who's not in the top 10.
Right. I suspect that there'll be some kind of build-up, press conference, whatever. You'll be face-to-face multiple times leading up to the fight. Do you think it will get tense? Like, do you think they'll have to bring more security and things like that for these events?
I don't know, man. I'm a professional. You know, like I'd like to say, like, you know, I'm not gonna do that kind of stuff. And that's not me. But you know, who knows what he's gonna do? I'm a man at the same time. So we'll see what happens. I mean, I'm not looking forward to that part of it. I just want to get to August 17th and you know, put my hands on this dude. But you know, this is part of the fight game, and we'll see what happens.
And considering the feelings that you have for him, is there any part of you that feels like you'll have to program yourself to not fight emotionally in this fight because you really dislike this man?
Yeah, for sure. You know, me and Duke, that's Duke's job. Duke's one of the best. Duke knows me more than anybody. He knows what kind of training camp we're going to have for this guy. So, I'll have to be smart. You know, I don't want to go out there and be stupid and fight him dumb. But at the same time, I want to knock this guy out. I only got 15 minutes to do it.
So has he already talked to you about that?
Who's that, Duke?
Yeah, about like that we have to not fight emotionally and fight smart out there.
Nah, I think, you know, Duke knows me, man. Duke knows how to make me fight emotionally when I need to and be smart when I have to be smart. And this is a little bit of both. You know, I want to finish. You know, I'm building off this knockout I just got over Wonderboy. I want another one.
So the fight is August 17th. It's currently May 13th. So that's, if my math is correct, what, 3 months away, essentially. When would training camp start for a fight that is 3 months away for you?
Next week, especially for Diaz.
What do you mean by that?
I'm going right to work, man. I can't wait to hurt this guy. Like that's how I come into this training camp is like I'm telling you, this is a personal fight for me. So I'm getting to work right away.
Okay.
And there's no weight cut, so I just go into training camp to train for a fight. So I know who I'm fighting. So it's time to get to work.
How much do you weigh right now, if you don't mind me asking?
Probably like 190.
190. Okay. Is that okay?
Yeah. Easy.
Easy. So that's like almost like a 3 month training camp for you. Is that typical?
I mean, for 155, I have to spend the first couple weeks getting down to weight. So, this one's just, I don't have a weight cut really. I mean, by me starting to train, turning out my training, my weight's going to fall off, cleaning up the diet. 170 is obviously easy cut for me. So yeah, man, I think it's just one of the things. I know the date, I know the opponent, I'm motivated. why waste time?
Yeah. And let me, I just want to ask again, if possible, because you have said multiple times that it's personal. There isn't a moment where this started or an incident that happened where this started where, like, the bad blood really began?
I'm sure there is, but I don't remember. It's been a long time, man, honestly. Like, I know it happened on the Ultimate Fighter show, too. Like, I don't remember what happened. On my end, I just don't like the guy. That's it.
And I'm sure you're somewhat prepared with all the theatrics. It's going to be, I mean, when you're fighting Diaz, you're fighting an army, right? You're not just fighting him sometimes, it seems. You're fighting everyone. You ready for all of this?
Man, I've been around the fight game for a long time. I've fought on the biggest stages, fought the biggest names. Say no different. I'm actually fighting backwards for this guy just because I don't like him. So it is what it is.
What was that? You said you're going to fight him backwards?
I'm fighting backwards. Yeah, I mean, I'm ranked in the top 10. He isn't.
Right. Okay.
So I'm like, my goal is to become a champion, and for this one, I don't really care. I want to fight this guy.
When you envision the fight, how do you see it playing out? Do you foresee stopping him early?
I mean, that's the plan. You know, I'm going to go out there and put the hands on him. And, you know, he's a tough dude. I mean, I've seen his fights. He's been around for a long time. I know his strengths. I know his weaknesses. I know what I have to do. Now it's just, you know, time to go make it happen.
I remember when you spoke to us prior to the Tony Ferguson fight in Las Vegas, and you said you were kind of, you know, starting to like the game again and figuring things out in your career. And after the Wonderboy fight, it seems like, okay, maybe you're just taking these really fun fights right now and everyone's really excited about them. It feels like you're in this nice groove. Like, maybe you're not fighting for a title next, but things are going really well. Do you feel that way as well?
Yeah, man, I feel like just the weight change alone just helped out the training camp and just made it more enjoyable again. You know, the weight cuts were, I mean, I went down to 145 pounds. That's a lot of weight that I went down. So, you know, I think we're just on the swing of enjoying it again, training for getting, I'm getting better in my training camps and not just doing weight cuts. So it feels good.
I know for a fact Nate is listening to this. Is there anything you want to say to him?
Show up August 17th, sign the contract. Nothing else.
I can't wait. Thank you, Anthony. I really appreciate it. Good luck to you.
All right, man. Thanks.